welcome to the seventh week of the Powering Agriculture MOOC on Sustainable Energy for Food. Within that initiative, USAID, the governments of Sweden and Germany, as well as Duke Energy and OPIC, promote clean energy solutions in the agriculture and food sector. For the MOOC, the partners are cooperating with TH Chem, a university of applied science based in Cologne, Germany.
How are you today? Once again, welcome to my lecture. Today, we will discuss business models for energy and agricultural projects. What is a business model? A business model simply tells us the way how a company makes money. To understand this in our course context, let's take a simple example of small farmers in developing countries. A family living in a small village in Kenya might be interested in installing a household-sized biogas plant and replacing the LPG gas with biogas for cooking. We assume the family owns some cattle, and the manure can be used as substrate in biodigesters. Now the family is eager to know how much a biogas plant costs and how much payment for LPG could be avoided after cooking with biogas. This avoided payment is indirect revenue because it is a direct saving. By comparing total costs with total savings, a decision can be made. For such smaller projects, financial analysis is relatively simple and can be done very quickly. On the other hand, a big project is relatively complex and requires higher expertise and bigger investments. There, a detailed financial analysis is necessary. Let's take an example of a grid-connected project that uses agricultural waste for power generation. In many countries worldwide, especially in Asian countries, rice is a staple food. You may already know you get rice by selling of the paddy in rice mills. The byproduct, or the sale of paddy, is called rice husk. A relatively big mill produces many tons of rice husk every year. There is no commercial use of such husk, and it is simply burnt. A rice mill owner, let's say from Vietnam, has an idea of utilizing this husk for power generation using gasification technology. Now, the mill owner is interested in its business model to support in investment decision making. There are two main aspects. The owner should first analyze the present value of total cost and the present value of total revenue. With these two parameters, the net present value of the project can be calculated. If necessary, other parameters such as internal rate of return or payback period can also be analyzed. Let's talk about the revenue first. The first question is, what to do with the electricity generated from the plant? There are two possibilities: selling it to the grid and earn money for the sold electricity, or use this electricity to operate the mill. Thereby, the indirect revenue could be generated equal to the avoided payment for the electricity bill. In both cases, the owner should analyze the further aspects, such as lifetime of the power plant, future changes in the selling price, as well as other financial and market parameters. By using the capital budgeting method, the present value of the total revenue from the project throughout its project lifetime can be calculated. Let's say this is 10 million euros. Now let's talk about the cost side. For the installation and operation of this gasifier power plant, in the beginning, there are project development costs, equipment purchase and installation costs, and some other direct and indirect costs. Also, during the operation, there are some additional costs, such as staff salary, repair maintenance costs, and so on. We are assuming that the rice husk is available for free. Furthermore, there might be other costs such as bank interest rates if the loan has to be borrowed. Also, at the cost side, the present value of total project cost can be calculated. After the calculations, let's say we got it as 8 million euros. Now, the mill owner can make a decision. The total revenue is more than the total cost. This means the project is profitable. And in this example, the owner could earn 2 million euros. Now, there is a good reason to conduct a detailed feasibility study of this project, considering all technical, economical, policy, and environmental issues at the project site. Now, let's go back to our old example. Do you still remember that in the second week, I introduced you a PV irrigation system? Now, we develop a business model for this project. Let me take my own example. I come from Nepal, and my parents own some rice field there. They produce rice during the rainy season only, as the farming is based on rain-fed irrigation. About 6 to 7 months a year, land is unused due to lack of water for irrigation. Now, my village has road access that links to the next city. So we are now thinking to use the land during dry season to produce vegetable and fruits and sell them to the city's market. There are two important points to consider before we make a decision. The first one is how much it costs to install and maintain a PV irrigation system. And secondly, how much we earn by selling our agro products to the city. Unlike in the previous examples of biogas and gasification, one additional cost component should be considered in this case: the costs associated with agro production, such as costs for land preparation, seed plantation, fertilizer, harvest, storage, transportation to the city, and so on. Now, we could calculate the total costs associated with PV irrigation system and agricultural production, as well as the total revenue from selling these agro products. By looking at the cost and revenue numbers, we can decide whether to invest in a PV irrigation system or not. Maybe you will be asked similar questions by your neighbor. Can you now perform this analysis and advise your neighbor? Maybe not yet. An assignment for this week asks you to practice such a case by yourself, and afterwards, you will be well prepared to support your neighbor's decision making. Now, have fun with the assignment. Thank you for your attention. See you next time during week 8.
Thank you for your attention, and see you next week.